Seeing your own body lying on the street. It's like looking in a mirror you don't want to see but can't turn away from. And that's when you realize you no longer know which one's real and which is the reflection.
Great idea, Baxter. Tamper with the evidence.
Backup? Who needs backup? You shouldn't have tried to be one of us. Man, you were one dumb son of a bitch. Sir?
Hey, Baxter, hey! Just get back to taking them statements. Come on.
Yeah, I'm the stupid one.
Look, this is not your scene, Lieutenant. Just pay your respects and move on, please.
Yeah, maybe it's not my scene. But it is my case. Tomorrow it'll be my case. And the next day. Until we catch him. You do well to remember that, Sergeant.
Look, I'm just following Captain's orders here. You know the procedure when a family member is... Yeah, well... Take all the time you need, LT.
I lost count of the times I wished you were dead. Do me a favor, Codman. Tell Julie I miss her.
She knows, Rex. She knows.
I need to find my killer's trail before it goes cold. I need to get my eyes on Stewart's notepad, see what they've learned.
See the man in the wood?
Yes. I saw him. He killed that man in the street.
I see. Look at all these people. He's got family.
It'd be nice to know what they're talking about.
I gotta see if they found any leads that I don't already know about.
Clues here have gotta tell me something.
What a night, huh, Robinson?
Yeah.
Crazy. Ronan. Unbelievable.
I don't get it. What was he even doing here?
Asking for it. A witness called in saying he saw the bell killer enter a building. Ronan responds, disregards orders for backup. Next thing you know, the bell killer tried to see if he could make him sprout angel wings. And then bam, 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 bam. Seven to the chest. Point blank.
You really have no idea when to quit, do you, Baxter?
But take a look at those tattoos of his, all that gangland prison crap. He was more criminal than cop. Yeah, you live like a thief, you die like a thief.
He was still a badge, dickhead.
Why is this always happening to me? All I want... Looking up at the top apartment on the fourth floor, I think.
Must have some clues. That's my way in. That's closed. Fantastic. Here's my chance. I just need to follow Stuart into the building.
I'm sure you saw the whole thing, and that makes you special. Always looking out the window, sticking your nose in everyone else's business.
I did see it, and I'm gonna have nightmares.
You think we've got enough nightmares to last us a while?
Don't talk about that. Don't ever talk about that.
I'm happy to stop talking. I'm trying to watch a show, you know.
Honey, they can probably hear you talking through the ceiling.
I hope they do. Every time we visit you.
Come back. Did I do that? Hey, come back!
Those notes aren't for you.
Great. Looks like some sort of code or something. All right, well, I made it up to the fourth floor before the police cart away the evidence.
And hope your luck improves.
It ain't about luck, Evereen. Got that right.
Maybe you'll teach us some tricks, huh?
Then I couldn't keep taking your lunch money, big guy. All right.
Yeah.
Okay, folks. I need you to keep your distance from the scene here.
What happened up here?
I'm afraid that's still under investigation.
Guy got thrown out of a window. We're still looking at the details.
Thrown out of a window?
Why doesn't this guy answer Jill? She's got good questions.
I don't want to be outside alone now.
What are they afraid of? That we'll be afraid of a killer? I'm afraid already.
Officer Morgan.
Why does everyone need the gory details?
I wish Scott would loosen up.
Get to the bottom of this. Don't you worry.
That little girl that lives here? She turns up. You come find me. Got it?
Her away, if it meant pushing her to safety.
Thank you.
these tenants, if they're still alive.
Thank you.
tell them what happened. They'll find out soon enough.
This isn't a party. This is a murder investigation. Why does everyone need the gory details?
By far the worst birthday party ever.
What do you mean? We got booze? We got TV? What do you want?
I don't know. Party, maybe?
Hey, it's you. You're famous. Check out the TV.
I'm good, thanks. Enjoy scaring kids?
This little girl cost me everything. It was supposed to be a simple job. Easy money.
What do you mean? She's just a kid.
It don't matter what she is. Her daddy owed too much to the wrong people. She was just an insurance policy.
Is that where you come in?
A simple snatch and grab. After everything was settled up, I'd let her go.
I'm guessing it wasn't so simple.
That may be, but she owes me now. And I ain't leaving till her debt is paid.
Cut your losses. It may be a while.
Don't worry. I can wait. I've got nothing but time, my friend.
They can probably hear you talking through the ceiling.
I'm sure you saw the whole thing, and that makes you special. Always looking out the window, sticking your nose.
Lost.
What's lost is my body.
I know I got killed right here. And I know it sounds crazy, but I'd feel a lot better if I knew where my body was. Are you a detective or something? You might be my only hope.
Yeah, I'm a detective. Any idea who did it? That might lead us to your body.
I know they were old people, and I know they lived in this apartment building. Other than that, everything is hazy. But I was doing a lot of drugs at the time.
Sounds like you do need a detective. I'll see what I can find out from any older residents of the building.
What's that gonna do?
Hey, shit.
You trying to give me another heart attack?
No, I just...
It was rhetorical, for God's sake. Come on, don't look so lost. Take a look around or something. You know, spy a little. It's not like anyone's gonna stop you.
Grace couldn't take the girls partying anymore, so she killed her and roped her husband down and dumped the body in Smithwick.
worry.
I should get back and let her know. Turns out, the reason you can't find your body is because it's not in the building. It's at Smithwick Quarry, about 5 miles out of town.
Oh, well, why'd they do it?
Your parties were keeping them awake at night. They finally got too tired and snapped.
I thought they were just being unreasonable. I didn't know they would do this. Thanks for your help. You have no idea how big a relief it is just knowing.
No problem.
You know, I never really liked cops. And they were always giving me shit, telling me how I was messing up my life. We never saw eye to eye on things. But you really came through for me. Probably should have listened to what they were trying to tell me. Maybe then things wouldn't have ended up like this. Thanks again.
I'd like to have a nice phone conversation with an adult without interruption.
Got nothing but time, my friend.
So which was it, electrocution or slit wrists?
The razor. It was only supposed to be the razor. That's what the voices told me. The music was just something to focus on until I bled out.
So the radio was just an accident?
I started the cut. The warm water made my skin so soft, but I couldn't go through with it. The radio slipped off the edge when I was getting out. And I didn't want to die. It was the voices in my head that wanted me dead.
I'm sorry, kid.
Shh. You hear that? Silence.
Dear, the church is always here to help. Out the window.
Gunned me down in the street and you didn't even check for witnesses? Like you're untouchable. That girl is my only lead. I need to find her.
Baxter hated the guy.
I think the hate was pretty mutual.
Ronan was a little rough around the edges. But Baxter, he isn't exactly Mr. Cuddly.
Yeah, but you don't think he'd... I mean, a fellow cop. Or anybody.
In this job, I'm surprised less every day about what people are really capable of.
I don't even know how I got here.
Listen, I don't know if there's anything I can do, but it looks like you could use some help.
I don't know how I got here, or even where here is. I can't remember what happened to me. Why am I like this?
I'm sorry to tell you, kid. But if you're here, it means you're dead.
I knew it.
Look, I'm in a similar situation. Now, I used to be a detective. Let me take a look around and see if I can find anything that will help you make sense of all this.
I don't even know where you'd start.
Is there anything you remember? It doesn't matter how small. Sometimes the tiniest detail is all it takes.
I remember lots of people. And this rowboat. Everyone was scared. And I keep seeing the name Monahanset.
That's a start. Let me see what I can do.
Thank you.
deeply missed. You are a hero to us all. She wasn't a victim. She was a hero. She saved a lot of people before her rowboat sank. She needs to know how much she meant to them.
Did you find anything?
That name you remember, the Mono Hanset? Turns out it was a steamer ship that sank right outside of Salem Harbor. If it weren't for you, a lot of people would have died. You're a hero.
If I saved everyone, then how did I die?
No, you didn't save everyone, but you were trying to. Your rowboat capsized.
I can't swim, so I must have drowned.
I'm sorry.
No, don't be. Thanks to you, instead of fear and sadness, I feel pride. If it weren't for you, I would never have known. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I'm glad I could help. Sanctuary. A place where nothing bad can touch you. But you can never escape the questions. They follow you everywhere.